Hello, this is Graham. Hope everyone's having a great day. And it's another hints and tips video and associated hints and tips card, which you can find available on my photographic blog site. And again, the link for that will be in the description below this video. We're looking at taking close-ups with the FZ200 and in particular using the close-up lenses. I know I've done a couple of videos before on how to use close-up lenses with the FZ200, but it appears that some viewers are having difficulty getting the camera to focus when they use close-up lenses. That's because the close-up lenses modify the focus range that the camera will work over. And in this hints and tips video, I'll show you how to set up the camera using each of these lenses, the number 1, the number 2 and the number 4. And with the associated hints and tips card, I've given you the closest and furthest focus points depending on whether you're using the number 1, number 2 or number 4 lens and the zoom setting that you've applied to the camera. Normally for close-ups, I will use the FZ200 with the camera set to the AF macro mode, that's the center position of the focus switch, and use AFS focus method with the camera set to center weighted metering. Because you want the magnification to be maximum, I will also use full telephoto zoom. So with the camera set to times 24, that allows you to get to within 1 meter of your subject. And you can actually see from the chart the actual field of width that you get at that distance. When you apply these close-up lenses, you screw them onto the front of the FZ200 lens. It has a 52mm filter thread, so if you buy 52mm close-up lenses, you can screw these directly to the camera lens and you won't get any of the vignetting that you'll notice if you try to use the conversion tube, the LA7. The weight of these lenses is very low, so it's not going to affect the performance of the zoom motor. With the close-up lens attached, and again using the chart that's available on the download site, you can actually see the distance that you'll set the camera to your subject. You'll also see the actual field of width. With the close-up lens attached to the FZ200 lens and with the camera set to full zoom, from that chart you can see the actual what I've called depth of focus, not to be confused with the term depth of field. I'm using depth of focus for the range that this camera will focus under if you've got the lens on the camera and it's set to full zoom. So for example, it could be from 40 inches down to 24 inches. So you've got something like a 16 inches of depth of focus, as I'm calling it. So the camera will actually focus anywhere within those 16 inches. If you apply the number 2 lens, you can get closer to the subject, get more magnification, but the depth of focus changes from 16 inches to something like 8 inches. And if you're using the number 4 lens, you'll find that depth of focus is only something like 2 or 3 inches. You'll notice the number 1 and number 2 lenses will give you fairly good results. And if you use an aperture between f6.3 and f7.1 to give you the best depth of field and best image sharpness, you'll get some good results. Unfortunately, the number 4 lens tends to give you a lot of chromatic aberration or colour fringes. And you'll notice that the outside edges become very, very soft, even at those small apertures. So I'd discourage you from using the number 4. Some sets actually give you a number 10 as well, but I wouldn't even attempt to look at the image on that. It's just atrocious. There are some close-up lenses you can get which are called achromatic. The one I use is an old lens. It's made by Sigma, and it's the equivalent to the number 2 lens. But indeed, the Panasonic's own LC55 lens is an achromatic lens, so you could use that. If you use that particular lens, you'll need to use a 52 to 55 millimeter step-up ring to allow you to use that 55 millimeter close-up lens directly on the camera lens without using the LA7 tube. So there we are. That's some hints and tips for using close-up lenses with the FZ200 camera. Of course, if you don't subscribe to my channel, please consider clicking the link above this video and then you'll be notified when I do upload new hints and tips in this series. So until then, thanks again for watching. Please check out the photo blog site and I'll see you in the next video. Bye for now.